applause. Thanks a lot, KHMS, for inviting me here. This is such a pleasant moment for me. I love photography from my childhood, and my parents supported me a lot. I love to click pictures of our environment and animals near me. I think that our environment and wildlife is the best one to be clicked. Before I leave, I want to take an opportunity to capture the moments. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, fairies, for coming here. We hope much more success for you in future. I would now like to invite on stage the most intelligent Indian girl. Yes, she's none other than Lydia Sebastian. Please welcome her with a huge round of applause.
Thank you, KHMS, for inviting me.
Lydia, tell us something about your achievement and yourself.
Oh, yes. I scored the highest possible IQ, which is 162, in the Mensa IQ test.
As far as I know, that's even more than that of Albert Einstein and Stephen Hawking, right?
Yes, that's true.
Really, Lydia, we are totally amazed. And all the best to you for your future plans.
Thank you.
So now, moving on, I would now like to invite India's youngest ever CEO, Angad Daryani. Please welcome him with a huge round of applause.
Hello everyone, thanks for inviting me here.
Angad, we were amazed to know that you run your own company where you manufacture your own robots at such a young age. How is this possible?
I think that nothing is impossible. I just focused on my work for making robots and software and got success. I work for the advancement of technology for humanity, and I strongly believe that the path humanity follows needs to be pivoted for the better, and I wish to spend my time working towards setting up those pivoted ways.
That's really inspiring, Angad. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
We wish you all the best for future. Now we call upon the stage India's Google boy, Kautilya Pandit. Please welcome him with a huge round of applause. Thanks for inviting me here. Kautilya, tell us something about yourself and your achievement.
Hello everyone, I am a child prodigy. I have a good memory and I know everything regarding current affairs, geographical statistics and other informations. According to researchers, I am a wonder kid and my IQ is around 130, which is rare for any kid of my age.
Kautilya, as you are called the Google boy of India, how do you feel?
I feel very delighted, but my parents and my teachers tell me not to be overconfident, and I give you all the same message.
That's so sweet of you, Kautilya. Thanks for coming here. I now call upon the stage the girl who is even faster than the calculator. So please welcome none other than Priyanshi Somani.
For inviting me here.
Priyanshi, we know that you have your name in the Limca Book of World Records for being the youngest to hold a cup in the Mental Max World Cup 2010. So, tell us something about your story.
At the age of 12, I became the youngest participant of Mental Calculation World Cup in 2010. I was the only one who had 100% accuracy in addition, multiplication and square root. I have been included in Limca Books of World Records.
So Priyanshi, any tips that you would like to share with us to improve our maths?
Well, I just want to say that maths can be improved by having focus, interest, concentration and practice.
Thanks Priyanshi, and hope you will achieve even higher levels of endeavors and achievements. Now, I would like to call upon the stage a young Nepali, Temba Tisheri Shekha. Please welcome him with a huge round of applause. He is the youngest to climb Mount Everest.
Hello everyone. Thanks a lot for inviting me here.
So Temba,
something new, and I love adventures. Hence I tried it and got success. I had never expected that this will bring my name in the Guinness Book of World Records.
Oh, so you hit two targets by just one adventure. That's nice. Well, thanks for coming here and wish you all the best for your future plans. So moving on, I now call upon the youngest person to speak 23 languages. Yes, you heard it right. The youngest to speak 23 languages. So please welcome none other than UK's Timothy Donner.
Bonjour, ni hao, suprabhat.
Okay, so this all meant a hello. And by this, Tim has given us an explanation of his achievement. Tim, this is a bit rare that someone has a hobby to learn new languages. So, what do you feel about your hobby?
Well, I thought that language should not be a barrier between two people if they want to communicate with each other. So, I learned 23 languages. I want to learn even more.
Okay, so all the best for that and thanks for coming here. So moving on, I will now call upon the youngest person to reach South Pole. So please welcome none other than UK's Lewis Clark.
Hello, I'm Lewis Clark. I am youngest to reach South Pole and I lived there almost 15 days. I love adventure and I even love to make records. Hence, I went for this exciting journey. Thank you KHMS for inviting me and happy Children's Day.
So this was inspiring for all of us. And now, I call upon the last but not the least. She is a girl who does not need an introduction. Her Nobel Peace Prize is enough to describe her. So please welcome none other than Malala Yousafzai.
Thanks a lot, KHMS. It's so good to meet all of you.
Malala, we know that you struggled to save young children even when you were physically harmed for the same. You even tried for peace. So tell us something about yourself.
Some people call me the girl who was shot by Taliban. As far as I know, I'm a committed and even stubborn person who wants to see every child of the world getting quality education. When terrorism began in Spire Valley, I had two options. One was to remain silent and wait to be killed. And the second was to speak up and then be killed. I chose the second one. I decided to speak up.
So Malala, any message that you would like to give to the other children?